Hey guys, how y'all doing today? Today we are going to take a short destination flight from Salt Lake City, Utah to Jackson Hole, Wyoming. I put in a flight plan on SimBrief and I'm going to input that into the MDCU's computer. Like I said, I'm going to start trying to learn this, try to learn a little more and start inputting my own flight plans before I take the flight and stop doing it in the lobby. Even though doing it in the lobby is a lot quicker and easier. Got the M. Let me see something. Hold on. A FMS system, whatever you want to call it. People call it different things. Share the stream. All righty, we are good to go. Got everything on my iPad. I told you I bought an iPad Mini 6. And it's very useful for all this stuff here. Proper weather. So we got wind out of 299 knots in Salt Lake City. Got temperature 16 degrees Celsius. Got altimeter rating. Should be good to go here. Sunny. As you can see, sunny. Scattered clouds, not too much. So we should be able to see. I heard this flight is beautiful. Seeing the mountains and everything, so I wanted to do it on a clear day so we can see everything. We'll get started here shortly. So I tell you what, let's get the batteries going. All external power going here. While we wait, light breaking here. Seatbelt light, no smoking light. Got nav light going. Strobe lights to auto. Before I start the computer, let me get ground services. I want to get take that to zero. Catering services going. Baggage. Power supply. Jetway. Yeah, we're coming in here. Safety, after warning, I'll come on here. Right. Got everything loading up. They are doing that. Everybody getting seated. Let's with our flight plan. Like my first time doing this, so bear with me. Takes a minute. All right, we got our destinations in, from and to. So now we need to put in our flight number, which is me, but that's a good thing. Time management. Flight number is 4687. Our cost index is 8. Cruise altitude is flight level 320, which I think is a little high, but whatever. That's what Sim Brief said, so we'll put it in, see how it goes. All right, got that done. So now we need to set up our flight plan. Oh, there we go. Go from, we need to set up our departure, which we are taking off from runway 34 right. Yep. And our next, I can't really get the terms. You got SID stars, you got airways, you got all of that, transitions. I don't know all of the terms yet, so I'll just say waypoint for everything. That's the term I'm going to use till I get them all memorized. Rug D1. I did not see rug D1. All I seen was rug D2. So I am going to that one. I guess so. It's a SID. Okay. So that's, yes, rug D2 is a SID. Then this transition we have is HOLTR. Go there and we will insert. Boom. So now we have our plan, flight plan here. I like the way it. Whatever the VFR map. So now we need to do our destination, do arrival. I'm gonna do ILS 919. It didn't say Y or Z on the flight plan, it just said 19. So I'll do ILS 19 here, Y. something wrong here. Alright, let's see here. Yeah, Jack. JAC. Yes, that's what I had before. I like that better. Yep. Swing around here. Make runway 19 there. So, we don't have anything for that. We don't have a star for that. We just had a via. Yep. Insert. Perfect. Got our flight plan here. We got our altitude. Yep. Got our altitudes where we need to be at, so be able to know how high to be. So I think we're good on our flight plan. I don't see anything that's screwed up. We don't have anything that's messed up there. So next we will do our fuel, which I should have called the fuel truck by now. I should have been did that. Fuel truck is on the road. While we wait on the fuel truck, I will do, actually I need to put my fuel in first. So I don't have to wait. We'll hit fuel. And my fuel block is 3960. Everything's in kilograms. I forgot to change it. Got 3960. No, actually, that's in pounds. So we got 3960 pounds to kilograms. Quick calculation. That's 8,135 pounds. 8,135 pounds. Boom, right there. Close enough. We ain't gonna be able to get it exactly. Beautiful day, man. Look at that. It's gonna be a beautiful flight, I know it. Alrighty, so now that we got our fuel in, let's do our performance. This is our last one. So we will just put our flaps in, which will be at flaps one. Is standard unless it's bad weather or we're extra heavy, then we'll go flaps two. We double click that and it will calculate our VR speeds. are good to go. V1 at 138 knots.
Okay.
Everything else is good. So now that we have that, we'll get everything else ready. Flight level 320. I'm gonna go on ahead and put that in flight level 320 here. Jetway, our fuel truck right there. Hey, what I'm heading here. Alright, fuel truck came. Already got our fuel in. 8,442 pounds. So we're good on that tip. Off. Jetway disconnection. Power supply end. I should be pulling off. And I think all of our pre-flight stuff is done, so now we can just focus on getting everything started and back to clearance. Far north. Quite yet. Everything started here. Got our cruise altitude flight director. We got our flaps in, nav lights. Let's go beacon lights on. This is the Bredic livery of the A320neo. Got our fuel. Let's get our APU started. I need to be ready to taxi because as soon as I hit this, automatically by default want to push back, I believe. Keep that up there. Now all I need right now, this is the getting ready to push back. I'm going to turn off the parking brake. Set the APU bleed. And we're pushing back to the right. Check real quick. Back to the left. parking brake on. Let's get our engine started. Blue pumps. Our engine two first. Watch it spool up. Okay, Jackson Hole Airport weather, Jackson, Wyoming, 49 degrees, 16 mile per hour wind, so we'll have a little bit of a challenge. Wow, it's going to be snowing there tomorrow, Monday and Tuesday. Partly cloudy, look like. Hopefully we'll still be able to get some good views. There's our hydraulics. All right, let's get one started. Look at that backdrop, that's beautiful. Since I'm getting that done, let me get our taxi clearance. Pardon north. Okay, there we go. Taxi hold short, runway 34 right. Taxi. Alrighty. Why I got a taxi ribbon on, because I turned that off. Where is that? See? I don't even know why that's on. I got it off. It won't even let me. I mean, it won't even give me the option, but whatever. Laps one. Arm our speed brake. Let's go. Still make sure we stabilize. Yep, stabilize. Turn off the APU. And let's go taxi lights. And what else we need? External power switch off. Strobes auto. All right, I think we're ready to taxi up out of here. FR map, because that helps me taxi. It's very difficult at times to see where in the heck you are going. Alrighty. Break off. Thank you. using the T-Flight HOTUS. Now how can I get the taxi ribbons off, man? I got them turned off. That's why it's not even giving me the... not even letting me click it, but I don't know why they on, so whatever. Oh, look at that glitch. I'm gonna go over there. Stay on this side. Got some construction going on our left. That's crazy. See how this flight plan gonna work. That's my first flight plan I inputted. Shouts out to Sim Pilot Spud, I think, of this channel, I'm pretty sure. I've been peeping this channel, man, learning a lot from him. Squared away, man, he got it figured out. Ground speed 19 knots, that's where we want to be. I think it's for Simmers. I mean, I love their liveries as well, but they don't have a sound pack. I mean, the sound pack, oh my goodness, I just love the way these engines sound. Stay off. I think we are good to go. Auto brake max. Everything else should be squared away. Keep brakes on. Flaps one. We're good to go. We're gonna go 50%. We're gonna go flex. Alrighty, we should be good to go. We'll fire up to 10,000. Let's go 50%. Stick 100 knots check. 120. 140. V1 rotate. All over the place on that runway. Uh oh. Crosswind. By the rate, gear up. I've been playing the hard on this, man. It is crazy. Like playing with no assist. It's difficult, I ain't gonna lie. Okay, we're gonna fly up to 10,000. Turn that off. 1,000. Let's go autopilot one. Turn off our landing lights. Take off lights off. Light off. Anything else can stay. I'm gonna keep the seatbelt light on. It's supposed to be pretty windy. Oh, it changed right there. I said 2992 earlier. 998 right now. Right turn. Taking right there. Straighten it back up. Let's check our VFR map real quick. Right turn here. Flex there. Oh, it's pretty windy flying over these mountains, so get the seatbelt light on. Shot. Got to get a screenshot somewhere. Oh man, that's beautiful. Check something out here. 1,000 standard. What we came to see right there. Cockpit a while. Pay attention to what I'm doing. Point cloud. Six. A little small right turn there. Said anything, which is good. Said anything else? Thing, I guess. Need to keep my VFR map up though. Make sure we're following our flight plan, alright. Cap mountains coming, so maybe I can wait on that. I hope they do not have the land. If they had a landing guys on, I'm gonna have to pause the game because that just landing guys are hideous. Right, we got 32,000 right there. That is our. haven't lied about the views so far. Getting all this for free. Well, nothing's free, but this is a simulator, so y'all get what I'm saying. Definitely gonna take a snapshot of this. Focus on flying now. Get a couple thumbnails. We see something. Hero. Got 91 nautical miles to Moss. I will desail once I get there. 6,500 feet, I'm pretty sure they're already telling me. Shocking when they're not. Cheat us out of our views here. It's a nice view right there too. I know it skips. sell in a little while, not yet. For a while I am. Yeah, I've never had that, whatever that just was. Jack, love this app, this Windy app. It's 2997 is the altimeter there, okay. Start my sale right now. $5,000. I get one more snapshot. we are. We got 36 miles to be at. I think it's a 12,800. 33 miles now to 12,800. Yep, 12,800. See how accurate that is. That's what I got from Sim Brief. The flight plan I got from Sim Brief. First time I've done that, so I'm interested to see how accurate it is, other than using the flight plan system in the game, in the world map. Oh, that might be the one right there. We're in no rush. This is a destination flight. But already late. Already go to 98. Go to 98. Oh. I was having an issue with this the other day. Over there to open it.
descending super slow for some reason.
Why? Yeah, we got time. 11:06. 11 out. Ryan. We got Ryan. What, they didn't lie on the views, that's for sure. Left in a second.
$2,500. Flaps one here. Brakes back on. Turn on our ILS. Nautical miles away, 12.9, right on schedule. Laps two. laps three. I think I might have been doing something wrong with that. Might have did something wrong with my calculations there. I'm blaming the game. We are 10 nautical miles away. Laps four. Cool. Getting a lot of drag now. Go. Speed. 140. 40 knots. We are just about lined up. We'll approach mode here soon. Let's go gear down. Now let's go approach mode. Perfect. Lined up right there. By hand. Glad I caught that. Lined up here. Left here. worked out pretty well for the first time doing my own flight plan and everything, I would say. Runway 1, turn left here. Then just clean everything up. Brakes off. Flaps up. No, I forgot my landing lights and stuff again. I keep forgetting that. Makes me mad. Almost had a dang near perfect flight. Off. We'll turn them on like I had them on. Okay. Turn them off. Turn our taxi lights on. Anything else? Got that in the, believe it. Dang it. Having issues with the altitude. I freaking forgot. What's it set? Which it is. I can't see anything. Kind of look like that's like a, like that's a line right there, honestly. Yeah, this is horrible. I can't see nothing. I did a flight to Dominican Republic the other day and forgot my landing light. Like, that's why I was so mad. Parking brakes. And let's turn off our engines. Turn off our fuel pumps.
Let's see if we can get, which I doubt because this is not like a airport that they support. Let's see if we can get ground services. Yeah, it's no ground services. That's okay though. We made it. Thank y'all for joining me today and flying with me. I don't even have I don't even have external power. Seatbelt light off. We can go full cold and dark before we get up out of here. Thank y'all for joining me today. I will catch y'all next time.